This is a better trace. Backswing and get into your right heel better. Perfect position at the top. Transfer the weight. It's a nice braking effect here, that velocity. When you go to transfer energy to the club head, impact, you're about 50-50 with the weight. Heel to toe weight distribution is about 50-50, which is better than what you were doing.
Right.
Setup, you got a little bit of weight on your heels and your left foot, and it's about evenly distributed on your right foot.
Balance, I have too much on my right side, don't I?
It impacts. I think you have too much on your right side at address. I'd like
yes,
you
yes,
to get a little left.
Right.
And then start back to the right. But the net effect here is better with your hips and better with your weight. I mean, this thrusting of the lower body is minimized here. That's your big miss with the heel strike,
the fade,
right? And that causes, you know, that thrusting is from not getting posted up, not getting the left leg posted, and not getting the weight into the heel.
Right.
You know, for me, that's a big deal. So, you know, that shifting forward. But on the backswing, if you can load up into the heel a little better and get this right hip behind that box, even a little deeper than 56%, all your weight's on your right foot here.
Right.
But I'd like to see you get that weight into the right heel. Perfect backswing. The position of your club going back is really, really nice. Still gets a little in. Shaft's pretty much when the shaft's parallel to the ground, you're pretty much on plane there. Gets a little steep coming down sometimes. You notice how you're going back on one plane shallow, and I'd like to see it in reverse.
Right.
I'd like to see the club head stay outside the hands on the takeaway, and then the plane get a little shallower.
A little flatter.
A little more shallow coming down. So.
That would help the draw, wouldn't it?
It would, yeah. It would get rid of the fade. You know, here's a good example. Albeit this is with an iron, but you can see here. When he keeps the club head outside his hands, and to do that, all you have to do is keep your hands in closer to your body and retain the angle in the
right.
And so when he goes back, you can see the club head's outside the hands there, or to our right, and then the shaft's going to hinge through the elbow. And then on the downswing, it's going to shallow out a little bit. See that?
Yeah.
And I think that will happen with you too. So that would be my thing. Kevin Streelman here, he's a small guy. I think he's probably 5'9", the most. And hits it a long way. But there's the takeaway I'm looking for right there.
Right.
And that's pretty uniform throughout the shaft through the elbow. And then what you're going to see is a change in planes. See there?
Yep.
So, you know, that would be what I want to see out of you. Now, how do you practice that? Well, you see how deep his right hip gets there?
Mm-hmm.
He's probably got a little bit of early extension. I don't know. Not much. You can see a little bit of thrusting. Hips come forward a little bit. He's getting a lot of power from that little body, though.
Right.
So, yeah, let's work on the takeaway a little bit, like putting a shaft at about a 45-degree angle on the ground and just making sure they match up, the one that you're holding, that the parallel position should be parallel to the one on the ground.
Okay.
Yeah.